Right, so there we go. Caster's choice, lime green. It's as fluorescent as I can get it, Clayton. So today's colors are brought to you by Clayton, my sticker board swap sticker person. I'm gonna go with some botanical. And now, some pigment paste, red pigment paste from Totally Boat, in this one. I don't know why you want a Christmas colors, but Christmas colors is what we're doing. Oh boy, this can be fun. That's red, but... Alright, and now I'm going to add a color to this because Christmas in April just doesn't sound right at Easter. Even though I'm not doing an Easter project, but I'm going to do black. In there, by the way. So maybe. Yep, there we go. Alright. It's definitely red. A bit different looking. There's a crack right here. It's here. I don't know if I'm gonna miss it or not. I am going to try to go with it like this instead of taking up another day. So I'm going to, we'll take this down. So this is just to get it flat. This thing works wonders. So hang tight. Well, you get the idea. I'll be back in a minute. Thank you. through the side. Is that the same crack? Yes. All right. For the most part, I like it. I'm kind of surprised at how the colors turned out. One thing I don't like is that big crack right there. And that is the same one that was over there. So I'm going to keep going. Hopefully it stays together enough that I can UV resin it or something. I got another one here. I shouldn't have cracks in it. There wasn't even that much resin, but as you can know, you see it right there. All there, and then, like I said, there's another one right there. So we'll see. Aside from that, I like how the colors are intermingling there, except for that crack. So I got to get that out of there. Clearly, we're going to get somewhere down into that, but. It's awful. Oh! I'm not even sure why it did that. It wasn't like it was way too much resin. All right, let me give it some better shape so we can get some of that out of there and get into the wood. Okay, so I'm liking how that's looking. I'm really not liking how that's looking. I'm glad I cut this, because this one here probably wouldn't have gotten filled and I'd had to do it again. So what I'm going to do is probably a piece of plastic up here and pour it through the side. And I have that also. So the same thing, piece of plastic. And then pour it from the top, set it in the pressure pot, and hopefully that takes care of all of that. This is not really what I wanted to do. I'm not sure, what should I stick in there? Should I just do black? Black in the cracks? Because the color, red's going to be way too bright, green's going to be way too bright, so I'm thinking black. I'm going with black. There we go. Thank you. So, as you can see, I don't have much room in here to get my paintbrush in. So I gotta remember which way to go now. Which way is it? That way. Alright. I'm gonna put a coin logo in there and push it out. Hopefully my coin logo isn't too tall. And this will probably make it a little wobbly, but it's alright. We're not gonna go fast with this one anymore anyway, so. It's just a little wobbly. It'll be all right. You guys won't be able to see it from your house, right? All right. So now I have the ability to get down in there with the resin. Okay, so I'm going to use the Maker Epoxy, the art resin. I was gonna try the tabletop epoxy, but I think mine is old and yellow. So, maybe if I get some new stuff, I'll try that. It's supposed to work pretty good, but I'm not going to push my luck with that yellow stuff right now to see if it's going to work. So, I'm going to apply it 50 RPMs and let it be till it sets up. Alright, I suspect I'll probably have to do another coat. It was a little punky. Maybe not. We'll see. I will definitely let you know. Clayton's Wood Art. So, www.claytonswoodart.com. I'll put that in the description below. Stickers right there, Clayton. So, Clayton comes to Michigan, I don't know, 4 times a year, I think, from New York. And he stops here and says hi. And, you know, we just kind of chew the fat. And on his way out this last time, I asked him to pick a couple colors. the red was not his first choice, so. I went with those colors and I added black to it. I think it looks pretty cool, actually. But, you know, I was wondering to begin with. So let's first off go with the logo in red, but you see, it soaked it up right here. See it? This is the second coat of finish. I sanded it down. I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but there was a couple. I don't know how it got lumpy. See the... Is that whoop-de-doos right here? Whoop, 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 whoop. So it ran even though it was rotating. I don't know if... So this is the second coat. It looks pretty good, actually, for the most part. I mean, there's a couple little pimples in it here and there. You feel them before you see them. The colors turned out pretty cool. I like them. Really. The reflection off the lights is crazy. So it is Box Elder, It was a little bit of flame. I don't know. There's some in it, not much. So here's some flame. It's kind of light. This stuff was pretty punky. This one here specifically was a little more solid. That's why I used it. So your inside looks really good. So I'm pretty happy with it. I would have tried the tabletop epoxy like Ken Moon suggested. Says it's great, you know. But mine was yellow, as you can see. I told him it was old. I don't know if it'd be any good. So I'm going to mix some of it up and see what it does. I don't have... I don't think it's going to do very good at all. I can't even remember how long I've had it. So it was from my last rep, and I have a new Total Boat rep, and I've had her for quite a while now. So, So I'm going to put up pictures at the end, you know, at the end. Give her a thumbs up if you liked it. Give her a thumbs down if you didn't. I would say go check out Clayton's Wood Art. He doesn't have a channel or anything, so it's his website. Y'all have a great weekend, and we'll see you next week. Bye-bye. I said.